now we're going to explain how the units move around in the game. Now, we've already said before that depending if you want to advance or sprint, that will mean you can move two or three or one or two. I think a lot of yours are a bit slower than my speedy rats.
Yeah, smaller legs.
Yeah. So let's say I wanted to move this rat at the back here. So if I wanted to just do a really simple move, that's a stalker, and that can move two, three. So you've got the option of doing a short action, two short actions, or one long action. So a short action could be something like moving and shooting, whereas a long action would be sprinting, or if you're already in melee, you have to do a long action and kind of fight as well. So it gives you some options of what you want to do. So let's say I want to move two, and then I wanted to maybe shoot this poor GCPS soldier in the middle of the field here. So if I wanted to go two, I'd go one, two, like that. That's a really simple move. That's just straight out into the open, which probably isn't a very good idea because I could get shot.
But you can put yourself anywhere in that cube.
Anywhere in the cube. So let's say if I maybe move this bit of terrain here, I could actually go one, two, and then making sure I actually position myself anywhere within that cube, get some cover from this.
Do you have to be exactly in the cube?
No, you can overhang slightly as well.
Okay.
So as long as the majority of your base is in that cube, that is where you
count as being in that
cube. Yeah. Okay. But as you were saying earlier on, Matt, imagine we're in a 3D space here. So it's not just like you're moving around on a flat surface. One of the big things is that you can also move around up and down levels as well. And that might be to get a shot on an enemy that you can't see, or you might want to hide behind a different bit of terrain. So I've got my little, let's call him Sid. I've got Sid the Stalker here, who wants to move into this area here. So that means I can actually go diagonal, one, and then because there's a solid bit of kind of terrain here, I can actually scramble up that wall to get out of the way. So there'd be one to there, and I can go two diagonally, because this side is open, I can squeeze in there.
And could you go, if it's solid, can you go also go through it? So if you wanted to come beneath here or not?
So could I come through?
Yeah, can you walk? So you were able to walk up a solid wall. Can you walk through a solid wall?
No, you can't walk through a solid wall.
Okay.
Some of them will have gaps. So you might see this one's ruined. So what you could say before the game is, okay, well, we'll say that counts as a size one gap.
Okay.
So that means that a size one model could squeeze through that one. But obviously at the top here, that's a completely solid wall. So no, I can't pass through that.
Okay.
You also got to bear in mind as well that you've got things like half cubes like this. So obviously some of the terrain is ruined. So what I can do then is I can still go up. I can go one, two, and stand on here. But because this is half a cube, it means that the amount of models that can fit in there is reduced. So normally a cube has a capacity of four. So you know when earlier on I was talking about the size of a model? So a stalker is size one, so that means in a normal cube I can fit four stalkers. On a half cube like this, I can only fit two, because it's half the size. If you've got a bigger model like the Nightmare, that is a size two, so I can only fit two of those in a cube, or one on the half cube. So obviously at the minute I've just been moving. You can also sprint as well. So if that means I can move up to three. So I could go one, two, and then we'll still say that I can scramble up this wall. So I could go three there.
Okay. So actually with it being only 8x8 and a sprint of three, almost halfway across the board already.
Yeah, I mean, you do get into combat quite quickly, particularly with some of the vermin, because they'll have special rules which help them to move a bit further as well. You can also use the command dice, which will kind of cover in a bit. But yeah, you can say that pretty much you're starting to shoot and get into combat turn one, you know, which is really good because it means it is very fast. We've already talked about how fast it is to move. But you'll see there how, you know, because I'm not having to use tape measures or anything like that, I can really quickly get in. And then once I'm in the cube, I can then start messing around and deciding exactly where I want them to stand cube.
Okay, so are you able to jump through gaps? So, you know, we've obviously got gaps in various places. You've sprinted up here. In another turn, could your guy get to here? Now, there's obviously no solid wall here, but can he actually jump across that gap to get to me?
So mine can't. But some of the units, and luckily your GCPS have this, they have a jump pack. So a jump pack does allow you to jump over a gap. So of up to one cube, as long as it's on the same level.
Yeah.
And obviously there's no wall here for you to smack into. Yep. But yeah, so you could theoretically, on your turn, go one.
And
like
that would be one, two.
Yeah.
Okay.
You could sprint over and then potentially start fighting me. So yeah, so some of them can move up and down levels as well for free. But yeah, the jump pack allows you to jump over gaps.
Great.
So yeah, moving. I can't express quite how simple it is. But yeah, you'll very quickly be starting to move your models around and get into position ready to start fighting or shooting your cover now.